Hello, everyone, and welcome back on this wonderful Wednesday. On today, you will learn why God wants you to honor and obey your parents. That's right, honor and obey your parents. Our memory verse comes from Ephesians 6, 1 and 2. It says, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother." And to give you a better understanding of what we're talking about, we're going to watch this next clip on obedience.
There were three children, Jean, Tom, and Toby. They lived with their parents in a small town. They were sometimes naughty and would play tricks. Their parents corrected them and sometimes punished them, but they didn't listen. One morning, before going to work, their parents told them, "Please do not be naughty today, and listen to your babysitter, Miss Doreen." "We will," they said. But immediately after their parents left, they began to think of what tricks to play. "I have an idea," said Jean. "Let's sneak out and go into the woods. That way we can play instead of sitting at home with boring Miss Doreen. We would get back before Mum and Dad return." "That's a good idea," Tom replied. "Also, we would not have to clean up after playing in the woods," he said happily. Toby didn't like the idea. "Mummy says we should never go off on our own. Besides, the glowing one-eyed monster lives in the woods. He would find us and eat us." But they laughed at him. "The glowing one-eyed monster doesn't exist, Toby. You can stay home if you want to. We are going to have a fun-filled day." So they waited until Miss Doreen was making her coffee, and the three children tiptoed outside and ran off into the woods. When they got there, they played and played. After playing, they decided to head back home, but no one could remember the way home, and so the children got lost in the woods. "I am hungry," Toby cried. "I'm thirsty," Jean said. There was no food or water anywhere nearby. They kept walking. Soon it got dark, and it was very hard for them to see. Suddenly, they heard a rustling sound. They looked and saw a bright light moving towards them. "Oh no, it must be the glowing one-eyed monster," Jean cried. They started running. They were terrified. They ran as fast as they could, but the light seemed to be getting closer. Suddenly, they heard a loud voice saying, "Stop running! Stop running!" "Oh no, the monster talks," Toby cried. "He wants us to stop so he can come and eat us. Run, run, run!" They ran very fast until they could run no more. They fell on the ground, tired and out of breath. The bright light got closer, and they were terrified. "The monster is here," Toby cried. They closed their eyes in despair as the light got towards their faces. "I found them," a voice said. They opened their eyes. It was Mr. Goon, the policeman. He had been the one chasing them with his flashlight. The kids were relieved. In a few seconds, Mum, Dad, and a group of policemen arrived. They hugged their parents tightly and cried, "Oh, Mummy and Daddy, we were so scared. We are so sorry for being naughty. We shouldn't have left the house. We should have listened to you instead of being disobedient." And so the kids went home, had a bath, and had dinner. They learned their lesson and didn't play tricks anymore. They listened to their parents and were always obedient.
All right, young promise keepers, if you didn't know, God gave us parents to protect us and help us grow into safe and wise people. They definitely have a hard job to do, and they deserve all of your love and respect. Parents provide a safe home for you, clothes, food, soap, toothpaste, toys, and medicine when you're sick. Yes, parents can sometimes be overprotective, and yes, sometimes it's hard for them to let go. But it's not just because they're being mean. They want to keep you safe, young promise keepers. That's right, they want to keep you safe. Not only do they want to keep you safe, your mom and dad have watched you grow from a teeny tiny baby into the young person that you are now. And they are constantly amazed at all the things that you do. They pray for you and they make all type of endless sacrifices. This is why God tells us we need to honor and obey. We need to thank our parents for all the things that they do, which you can never repay. And there are many ways to honor your parents. I bet you didn't know. You can do your chores without complaining, do your chores without being asked, listening to what they say, and doing what your parents say without any argument. That's right, no argument, young promise keepers. We need to say thank you, we love you, and give them a great big hug. Aww. Now, with that being said, promise keepers, I know I gave you a mouthful, so let's do a couple of multiple choice review questions. Are you ready? Of course you are. So let's put our thinking caps on. All right, young promise keepers, our first question is, parents ask us to do chores to teach us who is the boss, responsibility, or the arts. I hope you said responsibility. Of course, parents ask us to do chores to teach us responsibility. Number two, parents often say no so they can protect us, be mean, or enjoy watching us work. Protect us. That's right. Parents want to protect us at all times. Number three, being a parent is hard, easy, or easier than being a kid. Hard. Being a parent is not so easy like you think it is, kids. It is a hard job, and God put a task before your parents to do, because again, your parents want you to be safe and grow up to be a successful adult. The last question, number four. God wants us to do whatever we want, obey our parents, or fight for our rights as kids. I know you got this one right, young promise keepers, because it's the title of our lesson, Obey Your Parents. That's right. God wants you to obey and honor your parents at all times. All right, that is almost the end of our lesson, our God work for the week. Parents, this week when you say no, just don't leave it at that. Sit down and help your child understand why you said no and the consequence you want them to avoid. Kids, see if you can keep track of all the things that your parents do for you. I want you to write it down, whether your parent does something fun with you, give you a treat, make you lunch or dinner. And by the end of this week, you're going to see all the things that your parents do for you. You'll also see how much they love you because they do the things for you without being asked or told to do so. That's why your parents love you. That ends our lesson. And as usual, we're going to end in prayer. So as usual, kids, let's bow our heads and put our hands together. Let's pray. Thank you, God, for giving us parents who love and care for us. Forgive us for the times we disobeyed and help us to honor and obey moving forward. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, young promise keepers, with that being said, this ends our lesson. I'm glad you tuned in, and I want you to come back next Wednesday at 12 o'clock. That's right, next Wednesday at 12 o'clock, and we're going to talk about trusting in God. See you soon. Yeah.